A number of different factors can play into why someone battles chronic dry eye, and it's a disease that impacts millions of Americans every day.
But one Mid-South doctor is working to help those who battle the chronic illness, and he's been doing that for more than 10 years working on this. Ophthalmologist Dr. Rolando Toyos of the Toyos Clinic. And you have a patent on this, which is not an easy thing to
get. Yeah, it took us 7 years to get it. We still have a couple more patents that we're trying to get, but it's a long process.
Wow. So what exactly is chronic dry eye? I mean, we hear the commercials, we see them all, hear about them all the time, but a lot of folks may not know specifically what it is.
Well, it's affecting about 14% of the U.S. population. I went to China, it's affecting about 40% of their population.
Wow.
So just picture if you had sand in your eye and every time you're blinking, or somebody's saying just to have a dirty contact. Every time you're blinking, you're feeling your eyes. And not only does that, it impacts your vision too. It decreases your vision. So chronic dry eye disease can impact your daily life in such a big way.
Well, and because this is such a big part of our daily life, I imagine it's getting much worse, and probably the number of people who have it is going to continue.
Yeah, what comes from using tablets or iPads like that and others?
Well, it's really interesting. When I started working on dry eye 21 years ago, patients were about 40 and older. But now we're getting teenagers coming in with this dry eye problem. I've got three teenage daughters, and they're constantly on Netflix, they're constantly watching their phone.
Yeah.
And what happens is when you're doing that, you're not blinking as much. And part of the mechanism for producing a tear is actually blinking. So we have glands on our lid margin that every time you blink, they're releasing part of your tear. And 90% of patients that have a problem with a dry eye have a problem with these glands.
Wow. So you use light. How does that help? Without getting too sciencey, it really sounds revolutionary.
It's pretty interesting. This is stuff that was discovered by NASA. What was happening, astronauts were going up into the space station. They were staying there for quite a bit of time.
Mm-hmm.
And when you go up into the space, your body slows down. It's the same kind of process that happens here when somebody has disease. Their metabolism slows down, their cells slow down. What we're doing is we're using light to actually spark these cells and the mitochondria of the cells to work better.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what they found in the space station. These astronauts go through light therapy to keep their cells working so that they don't age 10 years when they go up into space. So we're taking that technology and we're bringing it here. Now, light is being used in all sorts of specialties now. So you have infrared light being used by orthopedic surgeons.
Yep.
You have blue light being used by dermatologists to combat acne. And what we're doing is what I've done for the last 20 years is discover different wavelengths of light that actually spark the glands that aren't working well to work well.
So it helps your body do what your body's supposed to do naturally.
Exactly.
And a lot of people will wonder, how do you actually go about using your treatment? How simple is it? Is this extremely complicated or what?
Right.
So very interesting. So I came on this show about 10 years ago and I introduced intense pulse light.
Yep.
So that's a light treatment that we do in the clinic. It's very intense and needs to be administered by a doctor. So I started thinking, well, is there a light that we could use safely at home for those patients to keep these glands working? So that's what I discovered. I just discovered LED lights that could be used to stimulate the glands to work better.
So I can do this at home in how much time? Because that's another thing that people don't
have. Minutes a day, 4 minutes a day. So I tell people it's like brushing your teeth. Just keep it by your bedside or keep it by your counter. Give yourself a few minutes a day before you go to bed and these glands work better.
Should you do it as a preventative if you're getting to that age group where might be a problem, or is it not supposed to be a preventative?
Well, it's very interesting. These wavelengths of lights that we're using actually stimulate the skin to produce collagen and fibroblasts, so it makes your skin look better.
Yeah. Give to mama. So
very
come
quickly,
on.
What about you have a new book also?
Yeah, so it became a best-selling book, and it just shows you how bad dry eye disease is. It's called Dry Eye Disease Treatment in the Year 2020. It's on Amazon. All proceeds go to helping the poor. I take none of the proceeds for myself. We just give treatments to
All right, doctor, we appreciate you being with us.
Well, thanks. Thanks for having me again.
Okay.
Awesome to see you.